So now we're on to the arteries of the lower limb. So first thing we're going to be doing is, actually, I'm going to be showing you this little blood flow diagram that we made. I want you to just follow this to get the general idea of the pattern of this blood flow to the lower extremity. So here we remember this is the end of the abdominal aorta. Here is the common iliac artery, external iliac artery, and then that external iliac artery is going to pass under the inguinal ligament, and we are now in the lower limb. So we are, this first artery here is going to be the femoral artery. Femoral artery, good place to take a pulse check, real easy to get to. Now that femoral artery is in the anterior part of the upper thigh, but this femoral artery is actually going to go medially deep to the sartorius, and I'll show you that shortly. It's going to go deep to the sartorius, go medially, and it's going to actually go through an opening in the adductor magnus called the adductor hiatus, and it's going to actually reach the back of the knee region, the popliteal region, where it will emerge and it will become the popliteal artery. Now that popliteal artery is going to have a branch that it's going to send out to the anterior surface of the lower leg. It is going to be called the anterior tibial artery. So that anterior tibial artery is going to go all the way down the anterior part of the lower leg. When it gets to the dorsum of the foot, it's going to become the dorsalis pedis artery. Now that dorsalis pedis artery tells you it's on the dorsum of the foot. You will be doing a pulse check here, also at the dorsalis pedis artery. The popliteal artery will also continue on down the backside of the lower leg, and it is going to be called the posterior tibial artery. Now this posterior tibial artery is along the entire length of the back of the lower leg, and where that posterior tibial artery goes deep to the medial malleolus of the tibia, you will be doing a pulse check of the posterior tibial artery. These are going to be real important pulse checks because you are assessing your patient if there is blood flow. Remember, you can only do pulse checks in arteries and not veins. So let's have a look. Here is your leg model. So here is your external iliac artery. Here is the inguinal ligament. So once the external iliac artery goes under the inguinal ligament, it is now called the femoral artery. And here is the femoral vein. And this is actually the femoral nerve also. But just follow the femoral artery and the femoral vein. They are paired and they're basically traveling with one another. So here we removed, here's sartorius. We've removed sartorius and removed rectus femoris. So here we see our femoral artery. Here are some branches of the femoral artery that are going to be supplying blood to the quadriceps. And if we follow the femoral artery and the femoral vein, they are going medially inward. So here's the medial aspect of your leg model. Remember, these are all your adductors. So if we follow the femoral artery and vein medially, I didn't have a good picture of it, so I pulled this one off the internet. Here we have the femoral artery and femoral vein. They're going to go through this white structure right here that I cannot quite see here. But this white structure is actually showing you this is where the adductor hiatus is. So this is going to be an opening in the adductor magnus that is going to allow the femoral artery and vein to go to the backside of the knee. So here we are. This is the backside of the knee. So this is the popliteal region. Here is that little opening, the adductor hiatus. So here is the popliteal artery, popliteal vein in the popliteal fossa. If you follow the popliteal artery down, it's tracking this yellow nerve. And sometimes it's hard to see the artery because of the tissue of the muscle tissue. It's the same red color, but that is the popliteal artery right here. So popliteal artery, popliteal vein. So follow the popliteal artery down. It's going to give some branches to the knee that you can see here. Those are just branches that are to the knee. But follow the popliteal artery down, and we are going to come to this branch. This is the anterior tibial artery. The anterior tibial artery is going to be going between the fibula and the tibia to go to the anterior part of the lower leg. Now, I actually made a movie that is not very good, but I'll show it to you anyway. And it'll show this part of the anatomy of the arteries. So here we go. So here we are in the back of the knee. This is the popliteal fossa. So here is our popliteal artery, and right next to it is the popliteal vein in the popliteal fossa. So the popliteal artery, follow it down. It's hard to see because of the color, because of the red of the muscle, but here is our first branch. This is the anterior tibial artery. It is going to be going in between the fibula and tibia and come out in the anterior surface of the lower leg. So anterior tibial artery goes all the way down the anterior surface, and then it's going to go into the dorsum of the foot, and it will become the dorsalis pedis, our pedis artery, and we will be doing a pulse check here. So anterior tibial artery going down, and remember, it's a branch of the popliteal artery. Popliteal artery, anterior tibial artery, and now we have the posterior tibial artery that is tracking that yellow nerve. And here is where the posterior tibial artery is going to go deep to the medial malleolus, and we are going to be doing a pulse check here. So pulse check of the posterior tibial artery is going to be right here at the medial malleolus. Well, hopefully that was somewhat helpful. Anyway, here is a model from the classroom too. I am not very fond of this 2D model, but I will show it to you anyway. Here is our femoral artery. You really cannot appreciate how this is anterior and then it pierces through the adductor hiatus to go into the popliteal region behind the knee. But it is what it is. Femoral artery going into the popliteal artery once it's in the popliteal region. The first branch that we see right here, this is the anterior tibial artery. It's actually going to be wrapping around up front to the lower anterior leg. And here we can see part of it peeking out here. This is the anterior tibial artery going into the dorsum of the foot. So this would be the dorsalis pedis artery, and you'd be doing a pulse check here. Go back to the popliteal artery. Here is going to be the posterior tibial artery going down the entire length of the lower back leg. At the medial malleolus of the tibia, you would be doing a pulse check of the posterior tibial artery. On this side, we are seeing the femoral artery. You can kind of see it going in medially, and then we lose it. We do not see the popliteal artery at all, but we do see the anterior tibial artery. Remember, it came out in between the fibula and tibia. So here is the anterior tibial artery going down into the dorsum of the foot. This would be the dorsalis pedis artery. So just wanted to show you that. Now here is your worksheet. So this is the worksheet that I have. It's labeled for you here. Let's have a look at this guy. Here's the distal end of the abdominal aorta. Here's the common iliac, internal iliac, external iliac. Then we go under the inguinal ligament. Here's the femoral artery. Here's some of its branches going to the quad muscles. The femoral artery will go through the adductor hiatus and then go into the popliteal region, the back of the knee region, and become the popliteal artery. Now this popliteal artery will have a branch that's going to go in between the tibia and the fibula. It will come out in between those two bones to go to the anterior lower leg. This is the anterior tibial artery. Goes all the way down into the dorsum of the foot. And now this is the dorsalis pedis artery. Be doing a pulse check here. If we go back to the popliteal artery, here's our branch to the anterior tibial. Here is now the posterior tibial artery. Goes down the entire length of the tibia. And at the medial malleolus, it's going to go deep to the medial malleolus of the tibia. You will be doing a pulse check. Now I threw in one more diagram because you will be seeing different diagrams of the arteries of the lower limb, and I want you to not get confused. Just know where you are and follow the route. So here is the inguinal ligament. Here is our femoral artery. Follow it down. Here is the adductor hiatus. Here is the popliteal artery. It's now in the popliteal region. Here is our anterior tibial artery coming out in between the fibula and tibia. Anterior tibial artery going all the way down in the front of the leg, and it's going to go to the dorsum of the foot. And now we have the dorsalis pedis artery. We're going to be doing a pulse check. Go back to the popliteal artery. Follow it all the way back down. It's going to be the posterior tibial artery. And you will be doing a pulse check where it runs deep to the medial malleolus of the tibia. Now, peripheral artery disease. We are going to have problems with our blood flow into a part of your body that's outside of your heart or your brain. It could be in your arms, but most likely the peripheral artery disease that you're going to see is going to be in the lower extremities. So this is just showing you normal blood flow in an artery. Here we have our tunica externa, the tunica media, and the tunica intima. Normal blood flow. Here we see plaque has built up in the lumen. It's restricting the blood flow in that vessel. So anything below this narrowing is going to be compromised. The blood flow is compromised. The oxygen to the tissue is going to be compromised. Here is showing you a femoral artery. and the popliteal artery, there's a blockage in between them. So they are going to be doing a graft, just like we saw with our coronary arteries. If we have coronary artery disease, they can do coronary artery bypass grafts. They're doing a bypass graft here too. They're bypassing the blockage connecting the femoral artery with the distal end of the popliteal artery. So this is kind of cool. These are angiograms. An angiogram is just showing you arteries that have been filled with some type of dye so you can see them. And these angiograms are of the lower extremity. So patient A, this is normal. Here we see the abdominal aorta. Here is the common iliac. And kind of see the internal iliacs. Internal iliacs, and then the external iliac. Here's going to be the inguinal ligament about right here. So now we have the femoral artery. Femoral artery is going to go down in through the adductor hiatus into the popliteal region. So we're going to, in the popliteal fossa here. Here is the anterior tibial artery and posterior tibial artery. This is completely normal. This patient has really good pulses. Has a good femoral pulse, good popliteal pulse, good dorsalis pedis pulse, and posterior tibial artery pulse. Patient B, this is not normal. It doesn't even look vaguely like this. You see lots of area where you have severe restriction in blood flow. In fact, here we don't even see a popliteal artery. This is a graft. This is a prior graft for this patient. So we have a graft from the femoral artery, and it looks like it's going to the anterior tibial artery. So there is a graft right here because it looks like the popliteal artery was completely blocked. Now, what happens if you do not have good blood flow to your tissue? You will get what they call these ulcers. These ulcers, they're non-healing. They just can't heal because they don't have adequate oxygen. So you can imagine the pulses in these people are very weak, or maybe you can't even feel them. Here they're checking a dorsalis pedis pulse. By the looks of these toes, there is not one. What happens with no blood flow at all, pretty soon there's not enough oxygen for the tissue, and the tissue will die, and this is gangrene, dead tissue. So that's it for the lower extremity arteries, and now it's on to the veins.